Hello everyone, my name is Sapna. I am a mentor working with one of the SRLMs.
Hello everyone, I am Kusum. I am a Vitta Sakhi and I am supported by my mentor, Sapna Madam.
NRLM has taken the initiative of supporting women entrepreneurs in SHGs for individual enterprise loans. I and my Vitta Sakhi Kusum will discuss about different aspects related to this initiative and we hope that you all will also find our conversations helpful. So, let's start.
Interest rate concept. Hello everyone. In this video, we will learn about the concept of interest rate and the two methods of charging interest, that is, the flat rate and the declining rate.
Hello Sapna Madam, as we are now trying to spread awareness about the micro-enterprise loans, SHG members ask a lot of questions about interest rates. They ask questions like, how do banks calculate interest amount? On what amount is interest charged? What happens if loan is repaid earlier? Do banks still charge interest on full tenure? Etc. Madam, I think it is very important for Vitta Sakhis like me to have clarity on this.
Yes, Kusum, you are right. When you are supporting entrepreneurs to get micro-enterprise loans, you must understand about interest rates. So, let us understand it. When bank gives a loan to someone, the loan amount given is called the principal. The principal is to be repaid by the borrower within a certain period. However, for providing the financial service, bank charges a fee called the interest. Interest rate is expressed in the form of percentage and for a period which is generally 1 year. For example, bank can say that its interest rate is 12% per annum. This means that the bank will charge rupees 12 for every rupees 100 lent for a period of 1 year. Stating interest rate this way helps one to calculate the actual interest amount for any loan amount and for any period.
So madam, if I understand correctly, if the loan tenure is long or the principal amount is large, then the interest amount to be paid will also be large, right?
Yes, you are right, Kusum. Let's take an example to calculate interest amount. Interest amount can be calculated by multiplying the amount with the annual interest rate and the time period in years. So, if we have to calculate interest on rupees 10,000 at an interest rate of 12% per annum for 5 years, we can calculate it by multiplying rupees 10,000 with the interest rate of 12%, that is 12 by 100, and then multiplying it by 5, which is the tenure in years. So, we get rupees 6,000.
Wow! Madam, this was not difficult. But what happens if the tenure is not in whole years? For example, it could be 2 years, 5 months or 8 months, etc.
If period is not in whole years, you still have to write the period in years. This can be done by simply dividing the loan tenure written in months by 12. For example, 2 years, 5 months is equal to 29 months and in years, it is 29 divided by 12. Similarly, 8 months in years can be written as 8 by 12. You can use these fractions in the formula.
Madam, I think I got that.
Now you said, members ask you how do banks charge interest. Kusum, there are two methods of charging interest, the flat rate method and the declining rate method. Banks and other formal financial institutions always charge interest on declining method basis. Banks charge interest only for the period for which any principal amount remains outstanding with the client. In case of pre-closure of loan, interest is charged only for the period the loan was active and not for the full tenure of the loan.
So, this means if somebody repays the loan early, then the interest will not be charged for the full tenure?
That's correct, Kusum. So, now let us understand the two methods of interest rate calculation in detail. In flat rate method, the interest in each installment of loan is calculated on the original loan amount that was disbursed. Since the original disbursed amount remains unchanged, the interest amount calculated in each installment in this method also remains unchanged
and that is why it is called the flat rate. On the other hand, in declining rate method, the interest amount in each installment is calculated on the principal outstanding amount that remains with the client after payment of the last installment.
Let me guess, madam. Since the outstanding amount reduces after payment of each installment, therefore the interest amount in this method also reduces in each installment, right?
Absolutely right, Kusum. On a loan of Rs. 12,000 at 12% per annum, you can see from this table the difference in the interest amount under the two methods. In flat rate, interest is being charged on the disbursed amount in each installment. But under declining method, the interest is being charged only on the principal outstanding in each installment.
Wow, madam. There is a significant difference in the interest amount paid under the two methods. Declining rate is very beneficial for the customer.
Yes, Kusum. That is why formal financial institutions like banks charge interest on declining basis. But informal sources such as money lenders, etc. generally charge interest on flat rate, which is very high and also not transparent.
This was very useful, madam. Now I can explain it to SHG members too. The concept of interest and the interest calculation methods of the flat rate and the declining rate. Thank you.